So, welcome to the presentation on the socioeconomic issues. We're in term two with the second lesson, continuing off where we finished on a previous video. So, last time we started with what socioeconomic issues, and we know that that is the problems that negative affects people and the economy. We discussed that last video. If you cannot remember that, please revisit or review that video and make sure that you understand this term. So in the previous period we completed inequality and poverty, inclusivity and unemployment and unproductive workforce, and today we're going to focus on the following three topics, which is HIV and AIDS, gambling and piracy. I want you to focus on the definition of each and the impact it will have on businesses, as well as solutions when it comes specifically to piracy. So before we start, I just want to do a quick recap on inclusivity. Okay, so I know it was done in the previous video, but I just want to run through it again. So we know it's about not to discriminate and against people, against any race, language, disability, gender, and it means that everyone should have equal opportunities. Okay, so policies to counter it, we've discussed employment equity, Skills Development Act, affirmative action, as well as BBBW and PEE. The influence that it has on businesses, we discussed it that business had to adapt their policies in order to be compliant, and if you're compliant you can participate in tenders, which is normally big contracts, and if you don't comply you can face penalties or fines. Okay, now one thing that I want to focus on before we start is the purpose. When we think about inclusivity, it is about to make the best use of all the human resources in an organization. So if you want to be totally inclusive, you want to include everyone, so make the best use of all resources in the organization. Telling you this, I want you to make notes as I'm speaking, so you can pause, rewrite, rewind and write down your own definition based on what I'm saying. So the next one, equal opportunities. In a business, you want to give people with different talents and backgrounds an equal chance to contribute to the organization. So the more chance you give to people on an equal basis, the more feedback or the more solutions you'll get, which makes your pool to choose from so much better, the quality will be better, and everyone will benefit. There will be trust and good team spirit. If we continue on, new opportunities, as more people and different people get new opportunities, inclusivity will then have an impact on inequality. Okay, as a business grows, there will be more opportunities, different people groups involved, and then the more that everyone is involved, the less inequality there will be, meaning everyone will be equal. Jobs, more people will get jobs. Why? If there's more education, if there's more upskilling, then more jobs will be created, and that will have an effect on poverty or unemployment. Okay, so inclusivity means when you train people inside the organization, that's why you're that's part of the thing that you can upskill them with. As we did in the previous slide, skills development, that's where you get it to the new jobs description. Okay, the economy. New members of that have just gotten new jobs or was upskilled, they can apply for new jobs, which means a higher pay grade, which means they will now be in the middle class, which means there will be more spendable income, which means businesses will do well, which means the economy will grow. So you can summarize that to say, and these new members of the middle class can participate in the economy and then assist in such a way or spend their money in such a way that businesses can do well. And lastly, problem solving. There's a few more, but I just want to focus on that. the more inclusive your members are in your workplace, the more the bigger the pool of answers that you'll get. So if you've got complex problems, the bigger the pool of employees that participate in problem solving, the bigger the pool of possible solutions you will have. And sometimes a solution is relevant to a specific background or ethnic group, and if they're not included, then you will not have that simple solution that which they will then provide to the group. So inclusivity is very important for problem solving. Okay, that's that for inclusivity. We go on into the next one, HIV and AIDS. So basically, in recap, what is HIV and AIDS? It's the human immunodeficiency virus, and it's acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Okay. Now, the big thing about HIV and AIDS is the discrimination. There's a big perception about HIV, and that leads to people discriminating against a person that's HIV positive. So people that are positive face a lot of discrimination, and that's an issue that needs to be addressed, because that will influence their work ethic, it will influence their productivity, it will influence all the employees' productivity, their focus, and it's something that needs to be adjusted. And that's why perceptions are important to break, and to educate people into seeing the HIV for what it is. Okay, and how they do it is businesses can create strategies in order and policies in order to educate people on this disease or this virus. Okay, so when we continue on to the next slide, we see that HIV has got a negative impact on business. Now I want you to think, pause this video quickly, and think of three things of how you think a business will be impacted negatively. Right, I trust that you did it. Let's start with the first one, staff reduction. So due to HIV related illnesses, a business will lose a lot of skilled staff. Can be either they are sick or a relative is sick, and that leads to you don't have that staff anymore, so that job function is not fulfilled, which leads to another issue. As you can see, so you'll have a staff or a staff complement, but with this you can see that the staff is currently, it's being reduced, but the work content stays the same, so you sit with a problem. The next one is conflict. So conflict will arise between staff when they discover that someone is HIV positive, and that can be because of perceptions or not a well-defined policy in the business, but that conflict needs to be resolved. Now productivity, most people with will find it difficult to keep up their production or productivity deadlines and meet deadlines, and that's due to their poor staff morale. So it can either be due to a person that's HIV positive and that has got a negative outlook on life, and he's influencing or she's influencing the rest of the team, or the team morale can be bad, and the total productivity can drop. This leads to a high absenteeism, which from the illness, so you don't have all your staff currently, and that's there's also a lot of cost associated. Now you have to find or recruit or train new employees, so that additional cost is a burden to the company, which just places it back further than where the company should have been. It also makes the pool of available skilled workers so much smaller due to the rate of infection, and then other costs such as insurance, insurance funds, retirement fund, medical aids, are all high as a result of HIV. A few others to mention is the low morale of the people. They are preoccupied and not focused. They might be thinking of the relative that's contracted the virus, and so they're not productive, and there's a lot of cost involved in replacing or hiring or even getting a temporary employee to fill that gap. All right, that's it for HIV, the negative impact. I want you to think about this logically, right? How will it impact your business logically? And then you can use these pointers to answer the question. Okay, when we continue, we'll continue on to gambling. So what do we define gambling as? Gambling is to bet on something of which your outcome is not certain, or a general term to use for any game of chance where you play, where you risk lose money, and sometimes you have the option, you can sometimes win, but it's not in your control. You're not certain of the outcome. Okay, there's different forms of gambling. The time is, for example, your lotto tickets, scratch cards, slot machines, horse racing, internet gambling, the list goes on. Some people get addicted to gambling very quickly, and that's the part that is very worrisome about the economy or in a business. If the person is addicted to gambling, it can have it will have an impact on a business, and we'll get to that later. And the different types of gambling is there can be pyramid schemes, there can be illegal gambling, and money laundering, as you can see, lotteries, land casinos, online casinos, and sports betting. Now, I quickly want to stand still with the pyramid schemes. Now, that's a type of a fraudulent investment scheme. So, there's one person at the top. Let me just quickly go back to the pyramid scheme. So, there's one person at the top, right? And that person invests his money in a pyramid scheme. Now he recruits other people to be on the second level, second tier, and they all have to invest money. Now, each one of the second tier has to recruit people to invest in this company on a third tier and a fourth tier, and so it goes on and on and on. Now, the person at the top level will make all the money from the investments on the lower levels. The people on the other lower levels receive money from everyone that's below them. Okay, so the problem with this scheme is that it will run out of new investors quickly, and the moment that happens, it will fall flat, it will collapse, and people will be deceived into believing that they will make money, but it will probably just fall flat very quickly. Illegal gambling. Now, with regards to illegal gambling, there's a National Gambling Act in South Africa, and that specifies the specific gambling activities at specific venues. So it's not a thing that you can take lightly. The gambling activities are not permitted by the Act is called illegal or branded illegal, and one way you can see that is they do not pay tax because they don't disclose their source of their income. Now, this gambling may cause harm and financial distress to people who gambles on this illegal platform, because there's no information on the dangers of gambling. They will just draw you in and ask you to continue gambling and make it or to lure other people to come and gamble. Okay, and then another topic that is very important to discuss is money laundering. Now, when we see this picture of money being dried in a tumble dryer, that's a good image to start from. So that means if you look at a picture, you see money that was washed. Okay, what that means is the story behind it is you don't know where the money comes from. You just see that it comes from a tumble dryer. Okay, so that's a front. So you hide the source from where it comes. Now, the source normally has got let's call it, there was a some spots onto it, and you washed away the spots that will lead to where your original spot was. So that's why it's called money laundering. You wash it. So money that you obtain illegally in different ways, for example stealing, drug dealing, that is called dirty money. And they use dirty money sometimes to run illegal or legal businesses. So it will be a perfectly normal business, but they will continue to put money into the business with illegal sources in order to show that the money was that the money is clean, or it's appeared to be clean, washed or laundered. Now these options have a big effect on the business. So let's see, or on the impact on a business. So let's look at the impact of gambling on a business. So firstly, focus. If a person is a compulsive gambler, he can't focus on work while he's preoccupied with gambling. So this can be at work. If the guy is addicted, he can sit at work, he can take the work time and gamble, he can use work resources, and that is not right. That is a wrong way. Gambling in its sense, whilst working, is not right. That's the theft of that working time, that's stealing of working time. So that's one point. The next one is theft, that's physical theft. Addicted employees can steal to get more money for gambling. So they've got this bad habit that they need to fund, and they run out of resources, so that can lead to theft, stealing. Next one is local businesses are forced out of business. And that can be due to a few factors. The next one, there's a high rate of absenteeism. Okay, if you're a gambler, an addicted gambler, then chances are that you'll gamble in straight into the night. Either you win or lose, but sometimes when they lose and they lose big time, then that's got a negative effect. Their morale is low and they will not even want to go to work. So there's a high rate of absenteeism. And they are very unproductive, right? And that encourages crime and corruption. So because they don't get a source of income, they don't go to work, now suddenly they don't have money, and that forces, or that leads to them going into crime and corruption. Not forces, but it leads them. Okay. And last one, it will hide criminal activities, and it can lead to workplace violence. Okay, I trust that will make sense. So we'll go on into the last part of today's lesson, and that's piracy. So what is piracy? Let's define it. Piracy is defined as the illegal copying or reproduction of someone's product or item that will affect that business operations, for example, copyrights, patent, and trademarks. So I've invented or produced one unique product, and this is my way that I want to make money. It's all legal. And now a friend of mine says, hey, this thing will be huge, and he needs to jump at it before I get at it, or he will jump on while I'm busy, but without my consent. So that's illegal copying. So for example, let's say I've got intellectual property of how to solve different problems, and he gets his hand on the material, then he can sell it as his own, but that's the legal copying of that. That's called piracy. Okay, so what's the impact of piracy on business? This is purely called theft. Okay, you will steal the ideas from the person that created it, and that means that the person that invested in that will not get the return that he was hoping for or that he deserves. As you can see, quick animation. The product value now is impacted. It reduces the value of the product in question. For example, let's say a clothing brand, Nike, you buy it in shops for a premium price, but now next on the streets you'll find vendors selling Nike products, and it looks legit and real with the branding, but in effect that just steals from the company. It reduces the value of the product, and also the value of the product in your mind, your perception of the company. Okay, and the last one is it reduces the profit of the company as well. So fake products will steal profit that should have gone to the company, which means less people can get paid, and that will have an impact on that unemployment cycle that we discussed in the first video. Okay, how can we solve this? Okay, now we talked about that, how can we try and solve piracy? Now the first one is by putting on a copyright. So what is a copyright? It's where the owner of intellectual property, he's got the right to produce, reproduce, and copy the intellectual property. Okay, so put on a copyright. What can you copyright? You can copyright your music, your art, artworks, literature, etc. That can be intellectual property rights as well. Okay, let's continue to the next one, patents. What is a patent? That is an exclusive right to use or sell the product or your invention that you made for a specific period of time. So let's say in a pharmaceutical environment, they produce a new drug or a pill that will cure something that will assist you with recovering quicker after a training session, and it's something new that's not been invented before, then you can put a patent on it, which means for the next 2 to 5 years, depending on the years that you can put on it, you have the sole right, the exclusive right to make and sell and distribute your product. Okay, so this means it's a for example, as an invention, if you have a patent, you can sell it and have the sole right to produce and sell it, as I said earlier. So that's, for example, inventions, this scientific works, literary works, discoveries, etc. Last one is trademarks. Now, trademarks is when you've got a brand name, and that's what you normally recognize a company by. Their trademark, it's a slogan, it's a name, it's a symbol or a combination of the above that we just discussed, and that makes your product or your service recognizable to the public. For example, GLA's got that jumper, the silhouette jumper. Okay, so firstly, you need to register a trademark. So your company needs to register a trademark. Once that is done, you will have a unique mark that will represent your business, and that belongs to the business company. And that can be words, slogans, etc., like the Nike sign, but not saying fake. Okay, that concludes our lesson. If you have any questions, please ask them. Remember your homework, you've got the double period now, so summarize the work, read the next work in preparation for the next period, and complete the March 2020 test, as well as the activities related to today's topic. Thank you.